TicketMaster, exposing 560 million user details and card information. A TikTok DM capable of taking over your whole account, and hackers holding all of your medical data for ransom? This
is the worst!
Welcome back to the Cyber Expanse, where we bring you the latest cybersecurity news in a short and digestible format so that you can stay informed. And you shouldn't read your TikTok messages, because with this new attack, someone can take complete control over your account just by sending you a DM.
It's not true. That's impossible!
This zero-day vulnerability was able to affect any user on the social media platform. By simply opening a malicious DM sent by a hacker, your account could be hijacked, just like several high-profile accounts, like those from Sony and CNN. They were all affected by this attack, with celebrities like Paris Hilton also having been targeted. In response, affected accounts have been taken down temporarily whilst TikTok worked on restoring them. This attack, after all, didn't require a download, didn't require a click or response. No interaction at all was needed, besides opening the message.
I don't want to live on this planet anymore.
And this isn't the first time. Last year, they suffered a similar breach affecting 700,000 users leading up to the Turkish elections. And with the US elections looming, the hijacking of certain accounts would be a prime target for hackers. TikTok hasn't confirmed the full extent of this breach and have avoided disclosing the exact number of compromised accounts, only stating that it's affected a small amount of users. However, this is a platform of over a billion active people, so that could still be a damn lot. Like, 560 million is a lot, and that's the exact amount of users whose details were stolen from TicketMaster, the popular ticket sales company which provides ticketing services for popular events like music concerts, sports events, and more. Had a massive security breach with 1.3 terabytes of data put up for sale, with the hacker claiming to have the names, email, and home addresses, and phone numbers, credit card details, order history of more than 560 million people, which can be bought for $500,000 on exploit forum and also breach forums, which has seemingly been revived after being breached and taken down by the FBI just a few weeks ago.
Why can't you just die?
If you're affected by the breach, the best course of action is to change your passwords, and if you reused your passwords anywhere else, change them too. You don't want to appear on dhash.com. And also, turn on multi-factor authentication so that even if your password is compromised, they can't go beyond the login screen. But that won't stop Microsoft, as Microsoft wants to spy on you and give away your private information to hackers. Because with their latest Windows update, which they announced just a few weeks ago, they debuted a feature called Recall, which effectively captures screenshots of your screen every few seconds and creates a searchable database of everything you've ever done and looked at, so that you can access it later. Whilst it seems really cool to just be able to search for a term and be able to find anything you've ever seen, you know, replacing that outdated brain of yours.
No. I'm the upgrade.
The thing is, if you think like a hacker, that's keys to the kingdom. After all, it's storing details when you input your credit card information online, viewing your emails, and well, everything really. So it's a good thing that they announced that it's all encrypted. Oh wait, it isn't.
Liar!
Security researchers found that it's actually stored in clear text and is actually really easy to access, as you can access it from the app data folder. Some people have actually already automated the exfiltration process. Thankfully though, as a result of pressure, they have backed down and it's no longer enabled by default like they initially planned, because otherwise, you might have been getting stalked and you would have absolutely no idea. As with the popularity of AirTags and similar offerings, the ease of getting one slipped on you without your knowledge was, well, frightening, with many reports of stalkers utilizing the tech to prey on victims. However, the tech is still really useful for finding keys and other personal items.
But what I do have are a very particular set of skills.
So, thankfully, in an industry-first effort, Android and Apple have collaborated to form a new feature called Detecting Unwanted Location Trackers, or DULP, which can detect Bluetooth trackers like tiles, AirTags, Chipolos, and more. And unlike previous solutions like Apple's more rudimentary Tracker Detect app, This comes as an update to the OS, meaning you don't have to get a special app to be protected. So from now on, if any Bluetooth tracking device is following you, on your Android phone, you'll receive a tracker traveling with you alert, and on iOS, you'll receive a similar notification. And the best bit is the update has been rolled out to Android versions 6 and up, 9 years later, and it's still getting updates. And on iOS, the feature will be introduced on iOS 17.5 and newer. And all of your medical records may have just been stolen by hackers, as a ransomware has plagued several hospitals throughout London, like King's College Hospital, Guy's Hospital, and more, causing them to cancel surgeries and some services. As Cinevis, which is one of the UK's top pathology and diagnostic service providers, upon whose services these hospitals relied upon, being critical for blood transfusions, had all of their systems affected by this attack, with hospitals like St. Thomas's Hospital reverting back to paper to receive the outcome of patients' blood tests. I wish I could say this was a one-off.
But wait! There's more!
This isn't the only time they've been breached, as Cinevis's parent company has actually been breached 3 times in the last year. As like in June last year, where the French branch of the company got targeted by ransomware, with the data then being leaked online after the ransom was not paid. In this instance, whether the user records have been exfiltrated by the hackers is yet unknown, but to be honest, I'd put money on it.
All in, 6 million.
So thank you very much for tuning in to this month's episode of The Cyber Expands. Please like, subscribe, and drop a comment if there's anything you'd like to see next episode. See ya. Bye.